Welcome to Growing Palmetto. I'm your host, Alfred McIntosh. I'm the program coordinator for SC State's Community Economic Development Program, where our mission is to innovate, educate, and elevate the quality of life for South Carolinians. The program areas are community and economic development, education, innovation, and support, family nutrition and health, sustainable agriculture and natural resources, and 4-H youth development. We have a lot of specialized projects going on in the Community Economic Development Program. We currently have the following projects available to the public: minority and family small business boot camps, nonprofit development workshops, estate planning and heirs property educational workshops, and adult and youth entrepreneurship workshops. We'll be right back to Growing Palmetto after a quick break.
If I could be you, and you could be me for just 1 hour. If we could find a way to get inside each other's minds.
Walk a mile in my shoes.
Walk a mile in my shoes. Well, before you abuse, criticize, and accuse, walk a mile in my shoes.
Welcome back. One of the key programs that we offer in the Community Economic Development Program is the Youth Entrepreneurship Express. This program is designed to provide financial literacy to high school students and middle school students across the state of South Carolina. Here are a few highlights of the program.
The Youth Entrepreneurship Program consisted of an 8-week program of financial literacy in which I went over business plan completion, marketing materials to help them realize and understand what it takes to run a business.
My plan for my business was to be have hardworking employees and have clever and many ways to manage my business.
They explain each step of the business plan, the executive summary, the management and organization, different components throughout the whole process.
In this program, I learned what a small NASA's was, how to operate a business better, and what to come with when I have a business to be more prepared if I want to ever run my own business.
We have a bunch of strategy partners throughout our group, because we have 5 owners, of course.
SC State collaborating with the Orangeburg Tech Center, we just wanted to make sure that we could use the strengths of both organizations to provide the students with some tools, some information, some literacy, to help them understand what it takes to run a business.
The purpose of our business is to sell snacks and drinks to teachers and students at the Technology Center. Our business is a better place to shop at because we provide cheaper prices than any convenience store.
First of all, they were so excited that they actually got to work with 1890 on a project. It almost gave them the feeling of, hey, I'm in college already. So that collaboration with 1890 was, to me, it was something that I always think kids in rural areas always get to get that exposure with, hey, I'm only in the 10th grade, but I got a chance to collaborate with South Carolina State. So I think it was a memorable moment.
I think this is important for students because for the students who want to start their own business, this program can give you a head start of starting your own business. Like, for example, for me, I know I want to go into business one day with my mom, with her cooking and stuff like that. And I want to surprise her one day with her own business, but I got to come up with a plan to do so. So this gave me a head start of how I want to come up with a plan to do so to create that business.
Thank you so much. I mean, honestly, I wouldn't have asked for a better experience with 1890.
Things are beginning to heat up, and summer is right around the corner. And 1890 Research and Extension will offer several summer programs for youth. Are you between the ages of 8 and 12? Do you like rock climbing, swimming, cooking, and arts and crafts? Then register for the SC State 4-H Camp, scheduled for Sunday, June 23rd through Friday, June 28th, 2024 at Camp Bob Cooper, located in Somerton, South Carolina. Our second camp, which is Bulldog Ag Immersion, in McCormick, South Carolina, at the Governor's School of Agriculture. Bulldog Ag Immersion offers rising 9th through 12th graders the opportunity to explore all things agriculture through horseback riding, beekeeping, tractor operations, and a visit to a local dairy farm. Contact your local extension office for additional information or to register.
Welcome back to Growing Palmetto. A few weeks ago, the PD region and the Midlands region took 4-H'ers to the SC 4-H Engineering Challenge. Let's take a look at some of the highlights.
Very excited to welcome you all to the South Carolina State Fairgrounds today, and we're looking forward to a great day of competition, learning, and most importantly, fun. So I can't wait to see all your amazing STEM skills in action.
So we are here at the 4-H Engineering Challenge, and it seems like it's been very fun for the kids. There's a lot of different things for them to do. They have rocketry here, they have coding here. They also had a mystery challenge where they didn't know what was going on until they got to their teams and their tables and they had to build a crane. So it's been very fun watching the kids get to put into real time the things that they've been practicing and doing in the 4-H clubs. And I think that it's been very insightful for them and very rewarding for them seeing this happen and like the manifestation of all the hard work they've been doing.
It was good, and it was a good challenge for me to learn coding since I want to do it later on in high school too. I enjoyed today because it was a nice experience to come and enjoy out here what they do in the 4-H program. That is really exciting to me.
It was an interesting experience. A little bit of trial and error, trying to get the measurements correct for the challenge. We also used the resources that we had at school.
I enjoyed the day because we just went around and exploring all these different things that you could do. Thank you, 1890, for this great experience.
To come in here, they had a lot of opportunity to work together. They communicated, collaborated, went through the engineering and design process, and then when they came here, they were allowed to showcase some of the talents they already have, but also build on them because they were actually doing the STEM with the engineering and design process here as well.
Thank you, 1890, for this opportunity of letting me showcase something I put very much hard work on and passion into.
We'll be right back to Growing Palmetto after a quick break.
I debate all day. It's what I do. But there are some things that are undebatable, like your mental health, my own mental health. I was in a dark place when my brother passed away in a car accident. I've never been more devastated than the day I lost my mom. I was depressed, miserable, in ways I never imagined. I reached out, and my sisters came, my pastor, my therapist. They helped me get through it. I found that the more I spoke up, the healthier my mind became. The chaos that was in me began to subside. I was more focused, clear. When you love your mind, you can go so much further. That's not up for debate. Find mental health resources at loveyourmindtoday.org.
Recently, the CED team completed two boot camps in the coastal and PD region. let's take a look at the highlights.
So this is the helping them to sharpen their understanding of certain things, like who is your target market? What is the problem that you're solving? What are the solutions that you're providing that solve the problems that they have? So putting these things together and then being able to implement them to help refine their business is what we're really doing here today. And that's what they're getting out of this.
You have your where we want to go. You have your financial projections in place. You know what it takes to start it up. It's a lot goes into the business plan.
And one of the things that I really felt hit home is just the focusing on the challenges of the business, even from the activity we did in Tangle, but knowing that through perseverance, through listening to others, through just being persistent, that the business can grow and that we can grow, but there'll be some setbacks and times where you want to give up, but you just have to stay focused and keep going.
Gullah Renaissance is a gift and accessory business inspired by the beauty, history, and elegance of the Lowcountry.
First Choice Credit Solution is a credit repair service for college students and business owners that not only wants to build their credit profile,
but it will help educate and push the needle forward to sustainable, healthy initiatives for our children.
I regret if I never have come here. I just cannot express how important this experience was for me to not only understand my business, but to be able to learn how to tell my business's story. Because if people can't find you, it's gonna be very hard for them to hire you.
Well, this opportunity hosted by the 1890 provide an opportunity to gain information on how to implement, be motivative and innovative in regards to starting a business. So this was an opportunity of a lifetime. It allowed me to gain the experiences and also to be able to gain the resources that I need to be successful in implementing a business.
SC State, that coming together and giving us the knowledge and allowing their expertise and their portfolios that they built to exude it and allow us to take some of that up. So I can't explain it. It was the best thing I've made as a new business owner up to this point.
This weekend was so inspirational because you got to see other people's visions and dreams and connect them with yours. Listening to other people's visions, dreams, and stories brought back passion and purpose for me.
The information that I got was so valuable, I can barely put it into words. It was a great opportunity. It was a great experience. And I appreciated the fact that I had a group of people who were all on the same page. We were all in the same mindset. We shared, we helped each other. And that was the most impactful and most valuable thing that I've done in quite a long time. I appreciate you guys for the experience. Thank you to all of the professors, all of the mentors. Thank you all for this and everyone that was a part of creating this program. I thought it was great and valuable.
We'll be right back to Growing Palmetto after a quick break.
Black don't crack, they say. But it can. I can. We all can.
Reach out to a friend if you see them going through it. Learn how to help at seizetheawkward.org.
Recently, 1890 staff witnessed the ceremonial bill signing of H.3951. The Work Agricultural Lands Preservation Act. Let's take a look at highlights from the bill signing.
South Carolina rural communities are rich in farmlands that grow foods that we eat, produce fibers that provide the clothes that we wear, and timber that provides shelter. All are vulnerable to development. Sustainably decreasing these lands in these communities that supports the state's leading industry, which is agriculture. SC State PSA appreciates the contributions of these communities the farmers and their families, and we recognize the need to preserve our valuable farmland.
So we must be sure we here today are doing what is necessary to see that we preserve the beauty and the strength of this state. We in South Carolina, I believe, are in a better position than any state in the United States to succeed and thrive because we are doing the right things for the future. And 100 years from now, we're going to be just as beautiful as we are today, and maybe even more so.
Don't go anywhere. Let's take a look at what's going on throughout the state in 90 seconds. Thanks for tuning in to Growing Palmetto. I'm your host, Alfred McIntosh, Program Coordinator for the Community Economic Development Program. As you can see, the CED program is an integral resource for small businesses across the state of South Carolina. We hope you learned something new today, and thanks for tuning in. To hear more news and updates on our CED program and all things SC State PSA, follow, like, or subscribe to our social media accounts at SC State 1890.